Noem signed two bills into law at Mitchell High School, but state politics weren't the only thing on the mind of attendees. Those bills, one establishing a salary floor for educators and the other allocating $6 million to train teachers in phonics-based reading lessons, were passed during the session. Noem says the price tag is for both current and future educators.
And I think what's important about the amount of money that we're using is that so that not only can we give teachers access to that right now that are currently teaching, but we also can cooperate with the Board of Regents to make sure that those students that are being trained right now will have the ability to have that training while they're getting their degree and are able to do that.
The governor was also asked about speculation regarding potential future aspirations, namely her making the shortlist of former President Donald Trump's vice presidential nominees.
You know, my answer used to be that President Trump and I had never talked about it, but we have talked about it. What I have told him is that I will just do whatever it takes for me to help him win.
Noem says working with the Trump administration is going on, quote, offense, as opposed to the, quote, defense she is playing against the Biden administration. All the while, Noem is the face of the high-profile Freedom Works Here ad campaign, encouraging people to move to the state. Some in attendance asked why the governor is so focused on eyes outside of South Dakota.
Because we want to make sure that we have enough people here to keep our stores open, our grocery stores open, that we have roads, that we have the ability to have people that you're not the only one in your county paying property taxes, that there's more people that are taking care of our water treatment plants. And
that campaign has come at a cost of $6.5 million so far and has faced scrutiny from some media and state lawmakers. Carbon pipelines, landowner rights, and vetting content in libraries were also addressed at the town hall. I'm SDPB's CJ Keene.